Hello, everyone. This is Rudy Productions, aka Dustin, and welcome to Track Plan Banter. And with me this episode, I have my guest, Dax, for Flying Scott Films.
Hello.
And today's episode is going to be on quarries. Now, before we get into quarries, we want to talk a bit about, our layout building styles overall. So, quick recap for me. I have a pseudo-realistic style to building layouts. I like having like a two-way main line and having like obvious like branch lines and main line and sort of real life inspirations. However, I also have unrealistic characteristics to my layouts. Dax, what do you do when you build a layout?
So if I'm being honest, I don't build layout very much. I build sets all the time. I'll build a small little set on my table, on the floor, with background, everything. I try to make my set as realistic as possible, well, as far as you can get with a wooden railway. But when I
Right.
did build layouts a long time ago when I was little, I would make my layouts as big as possible. That was always my goal. Make the layout as massive as you possibly can. I would try to use every single piece of track. I would do it all around my living room. The upstairs floor would be covered with wooden railway. I'd go into my sister's room and through the bathroom. It was insane when I was little. Like, honestly, I have no idea where half of the track went I had when I was little. I'm missing half of my track. It's ridiculous.
I feel like I'm missing a lot of my track from when I was a kid. I swear a box was lost in a move. But then again, I was smaller back then. So it seems that as far as our layout building style, like I guess as far as sets for you, that would be pretty realistic. But it seems for you it's either uber realistic for sets or just big as possible with a layout, which I definitely do like, go big or go home, though I only have a small space to work with because I only have my bedroom.
Well, see, I never built things in my bedroom. When we moved to Wisconsin, we moved again after a few months of living in one house because we didn't like that house. So we moved to this one, and now we have a pool at this one, and so I can build these massive layouts outside. And one time, I rented out for like a week, and to stop rain, because it rains all the time, I put a waterproof tarp over the entire thing, which allowed me to have the same layout sitting next to the pool for like a week.
That's awesome. Anyway, so moving on to the subject of quarries themselves. So I'll admit, when we first brought up this topic, I was a bit worried because I have very few quarry destination-oriented items, but there are actually very many quarry pieces. Now, the only quarry pieces that I own is the quarry mine tunnel, which is an interesting piece. The one thing about the quarry mine tunnel is it can be hard on a layout to have engines go through it.
Is it
So
that
sitting
one thing that has the door at the end that flips around?
yeah, it has the abandoned shaft door at the end,
Yeah, it's got the
which
danger, closed mine. Oh, this would be great for when Steven kills his funnel.
yeah, and that's commonly what makes that piece such a pain, is because I don't know how many times funnels get caught in like one of the little gaps in that piece,
Oh yeah,
and
definitely. I mean, think about my Fergus customs. Those can barely fit in anything, actually. Like, I'm putting one of my Furguses in the tunnel right now, and there's a good centimeter, half centimeter of the funnel is hitting the wood. Not even the plastic hinge, but the wood.
Yeah, but even like official items, it catches on.
Oh yeah,
So
definitely.
can be a pain in the butt sometimes, but it's what I have. So usually what I do is I would normally stick it on a one of the stacking risers. I get like the crossing piece. And see, the quarry mine tunnel is at least supposed to have this little platform that sticks out so you can sit a piece of track on it and not need a riser. But that broke off on mine. So I would usually hook it directly to a stacking riser, and then I just kind of like have elevated tracks kind of just sitting around it to kind of create the illusion of this is a mountainy area that they are
So yeah, this
mining
would be
out of.
great for Alsted. If you covered up the sides with something and added some fake rocks, it'd look nice.
Well, actually, so speaking of the Ulfsted mine from the Crown Discovery set or whatever it was
Oh,
called,
that's
it
right.
was,
It does exist in wooden railway.
yeah, but I saw Thomas Wooden Railway do this, is like have the quarry mine tunnel as one side and then have it go up onto a bridge and then put the Ulfsted mine on the other side. So you have an entrance and an exit, which I think is the perfect way to do that, especially since there really isn't an Ulfsted quarry. Like, there isn't a whole yard of sidings or anything going on because it's been long abandoned. Mm-hmm. So just to have like a single mine shaft, and that's like Ulfsted mine, I think that works pretty well. So, you know, you can have engines come up onto an elevated section, enter the Ulfsted mine, and then come out through the quarry mine tunnel. And that's how, in a perfect world where I have all of the TWR I could ever want, that is what I would do with those items.
If I had all of the TWR I could ever want, I would have so many Ferguses and so many Gold Dome Jameses and so many Nafford stations in Bickerstown.
So, speaking of Fergus, we'll bring up the cement works. Perfect, perfect segue there. So, the cement works, the official destination, is kind of crap.
Yeah, it's part of the cement works. It's not, well, there's really never the entire thing unless you're talking about Nafford Station or something. But you've just got where they would mix the cement dust or whatever they've mined, anything, because cement isn't a mineral that you mine out of the ground, but it's where you combine or mix different materials that you've mined. You've got water, you've got gravel, you have other things that I forgot about the name of, but then that's it. Basically, it's the cement mixer. It's what creates the cement. But even then, it's not creating wet cement. It's just combining a few different minerals to make the cement powder, and that's what you combine with water to fill in your driveway, or if you've got an idiot kid who decided when they were little they should get a hammer and start hammering out the garage floor, that's what you do.
Yeah. As far as from a layout perspective, I'm going to bring up another sort of quarry destination that I own, and that is, like, the mountain overpass.
I've never actually owned that item, and I've always wanted to.
So the thing about an item like the mountain overpass is that this is basically how I, like, kind of fill out my quarry area, is, like, surround it with tunnels and hill pieces that look mountainy. I know I saw one guy's quarry where it was literally just the track came and then it turned into the tunnel, but there was then like a switch that came off right outside the tunnel, and then it led to just like two sidings, and then like he like sprinkled some fake stones or maybe Lego rocks or something like that around the area, and then, you know, there was the road coming off the top of the mountain overpass that ran perpendicular to the sidings, and that was the quarry, and it looked like a pretty nice quarry, you know, it functioned as a location. As far as on that subject with the cement works, I feel like the best way to get a cement works is, like, you know, you get an item like the mountain overpass or echo tunnel or the single stone tunnel, and you just kind of like have some of these tunnels converge at switches near a section of road that has the cement works mixer, and then like maybe have a siding or two to store some trucks, and then you kind of have a nice illusion of the cement works where the tunnels kind of almost act like mine shafts, even though they aren't. Mm-hmm. They're like their actual tunnels, and, you know, again, I say this from a layout perspective where to have just a tunnel like go off and just end is kind of boring and a waste. And that's where, like, we get to the, like, pseudo-realistic style that I kind of do, where it's like, oh, yeah, you have this one track that comes in, and then you see all these mine shafts, but they're really just tunnels. But I feel like that's how I would create the cement works. And, like, then maybe, like, throw in a shed for Fergus.
Yeah.
And maybe, like, maybe an elevated, like, either road section or maybe elevated track kind of going along the outskirts, again, just to kind of create this illusion of a mountainous barrier around the quarry, which is basically what I just try and do with any quarry, is just like, okay, there's this mountainous kind of barrier that's represented by an elevated section of, for me, it's always track, because I don't have any road pieces, but if I had road pieces, which I'm definitely interested in getting,
you know,
that's something I could do.
Recently, I got some road curves. I'd never owned any turns for the road. I'd only just been able to flip over the track.
So I do want to get into mentioning some different quarry destinations. So we have Farquhar Quarry, which is probably like the most important quarry.
Or Nofa Quarry, there's that. Or that's the same
thing. Well, yeah, it's the same thing.
Well.
So we have Farquhar slash Anofa quarry, which is, you know, probably the most important. Like, if you're gonna have a quarry on your layout, it's probably gonna end up being Anofa.
Anofa, yeah.
Then you have the clay pits, probably
And
the second most important.
cement work.
Cement works, which we've kind of already gone over.
There's not even just the standard gauge ones. You can have the slate quarry on both the Ishgard and the Scarlowy. Then you've got the ballast mines at the Arlesdale Railway. You have what, the coal mines. There's so
Yeah,
many locations for
there's the
quarries.
coal mine slash coal plant. Then there's Blue Mountain Quarry,
Oh, that one too. I forgot about that.
which is
Boulder
probably the
Quarry.
biggest quarry. And then there's Boulder Mountain. Boulder Mountain destination slash set is probably one of the coolest ever.
I
So,
never owned it. I actually have the take-along one, the
yeah.
original one with
I've
the
never
old
owned it
cover.
either, but it's one of those destinations that I always stared at in the catalog and was like, I want it.
Yeah, I saw it in Thomas Wooden Railway's videos, and I guess Milk Tanker Media's.
So I have one thing to say about the Boulder Mountain destination is that, you know, we have this very awesome item, this very awesome set. Boulder Mountain is a very long-standing aspect of Wooden Railway.
I wonder when it was discontinued, actually. Probably 2009 when Mattel started being dumb.
Well, Mattel didn't even own Thomas
Well,
at that
they,
point.
yeah, because they bought Thomas in Wooden. They bought Thomas in 2009, but they didn't have Wooden Railway. That was
Oh,
what?
okay.
That would have been Learning Curve. So it was like Learning Curve, Mattel, and Fisher-Price all owning same thing, and then Learning Curve died. Fisher-Price owned, or Mattel owned Fisher-Price, and so basically, Mattel just slowly took over Thomas's name.
Well, anyway, of course, it's the coolest destination, but it is for the quarry that only appeared in all of one episode.
Yeah, it was around for 7 years, and there were two different versions of it as well. There was the gray one.
Oh yeah, there was the gray one. At least that was marketed as being a Blue Mountain Quarry
Wait,
location.
then I'm looking at the brown one. Does that means that there was the Blue Mountain Quarry, Boulder Mountain. So there were two. Wait, that means that it lasted longer than 7 years. I'm so
Well,
confused.
it lasted like it's 7 years or so or
Okay, it was
whatever.
called the Blue Mountain Mine.
Yeah, and it was discontinued, but then like in 2000 when Tomy
12, 2012.
Yeah, it was I know it was like 11 or 12 when Tomy took over. They were kind of like getting rid of all of Learning Curve's molds and stock. So they kind of just redressed a lot of old destinations,
But
and that
even
was
with this
one of
one,
the
they kept the old
things.
mold for the Boulder Mount, the Boulder. I'm looking at the thing and it says trivia: the Blue Mountain Mine is a repaint of Boulder Mountain with a different boulder. The prototype Blue Mountain included a 2001 Rusty as well as a lighter color. Oh wait, so it isn't the same boulder. They just took off the face. Then why would they just release it as a boulder? It's just a why there wasn't a boulder at Blue Mountain Quarry. It would have
Well,
been
there
cooler if
wasn't.
they'd added Blondin Bridge as a collapsing thing.
I guess the reason it's just a regular boulder is because, for one, it doesn't make sense to have Boulder the character transferred to Blue Mountain Quarry, which I like. It's
I
just
wish they'd
supposed to be,
re.
this is just a random part of the Blue Mountain Quarry, and this is just a boulder that's at the Blue Mountain Quarry.
The weird thing about
Sorry.
it is that it has pine trees on it, and the Blue Mountain Quarry had zero vegetation whatsoever. And this has entire trees on the side.
Unfortunately, toy designers have proven that they are not always the most intelligent people in the world.
Definitely.
Wood. So I guess we'll talk about the Blue Mountain Quarry for a moment here, because there's a lot of Blue Mountain Quarry destinations, or maybe not so much destinations, but at least sets. There was the Merrick and the Rock Crusher set, and then the Deluxe Mountain Quarry set. It has like half of that spiral piece from the Rhenaeus and the Rock Crusher set, and like a quarry mountain piece, and it comes with Thomas and Rhenaeus. And I think it was like one of those 2012, 2013 locations. I'm pretty sure they're like the two best sets to kind of like put together to get destinations for the Blue Mountain Quarry. The Deluxe Mountain Quarry set, I think, is definitely better, but you know, the Merrick and the Rock Crusher set has Merrick. So I feel like, you know, putting those two together, using those destinations along with
Blue Mountain Mine, that's what it's called. Blue Mountain Mine.
the totally not Boulder Mountain, you can kind of create a Blue Mountain Quarry. And, you know, of course, you can work in dual gauge into that however you feel. Boulder Pass, which is like the little mini Boulder Hill that came with one of the expansion packs.
Boulder Pass, let me look that up.
I don't think it's actually ever called that.
The Boulder Pass battery operated set. And it came with what looks like Scarlowy, a random archstone bridge that's got two pieces and it's completely plastic.
I know that's the set that I got the name from, but there was also the expansion pack from like 2009 or something. It was like an actual boulder, like from the episode, the boulder, and it was a Boulder Mountain style piece like that, except it was an end piece. You couldn't have trained.
Yeah, I'm looking at a picture of it right now, but from that set. It reminds me of the one scene from Indiana Jones with the boulder.
Morgan's Mine. That was one that I forgot.
I actually own Morgan's Mine.
Yeah, that's kind of cool. Of course, it's another shows up in one special and
Morgan's Mine wasn't even named. Yeah. I didn't even realize that it was from the Great Discovery until I started researching Wooden Railway about it. And I would always press the button and be like, "Welcome to Morgan's Mine," and you'd have no idea where Morgan's Mine was.
Morgan's Mine didn't like get too crazy amount of merchandise, but it got just enough that I'm like, wow, this is better represented than Farquhar Quarry and the
would you make merchandise of bad things when you could make merchandise of good things that would probably cost less too?
Yeah. I was surprised at how many quarry destinations I found when researching for this recording. Because, I mean, you have, like, the haunted mine. It's a mine shaft, but it's also a switch, which is, like, really useful. There's the Gold Mountain mine set, which I remember seeing in the catalogs a lot when I was younger, and it wasn't like the items like Boulder Mountain and the coal station that I like always saw and always wanted, but it was something I saw a lot. So the Storm on Sodor set that ties in with Calling All Engines, and it comes with Percy, Airy, and Bert, and then like a blowover barn.
I've literally never seen the set before, but I've just looked it up.
That tunnel that has the trees alongside that blow over, that's actually called Coldy Quarry Mountain. But yeah, so apparently in the Wooden Railway universe, there is a Coldy Quarry, which fascinates me.
Well, maybe it's not by the Coldy Fell Railway, just...
Yeah, I would think that it's actually like a Scarlowy Railway thing, because even in the 2013 map, even said that one of the lines went up under the Coldy Fell Railway. So, you know, you could say that it's a Scarlowy Railway quarry, but it goes into the Coldy Fell Mountain. Let's see, just trying to look up.
Quarry Mine, or Coldy's Quarry Mountain, from the front, looks like an awesome shed.
Yeah, it does kind of have a shed-like look to it. Now, one thing, this is an idea that I came up with rather recently, is back on that, like, kind of using tunnels as kind of sort of mine shafts, is having a quarry positioned right at the bottom of the mountain tunnel. I typically use the mountain tunnel as Gordon's Hill. So then you have, like, the two tracks under the actual hill.
Yeah.
And the bottom track does look very mine-shafty. Like,
that's a cool spin on it. I like that. That'd be a fun thing to do.
You could have quarry items maybe on both sides of the tunnel and just have it kind of be a quarry area. You could have a standard gauge quarry on the bottom, and then maybe the track is an arrow gauge track. And one thing I would like to be able to do with quarries is like lots of like crossings and elevated sections around a quarry. I think quarries are the best place to have tracks crossing over each other.
Or shunting yard.
I feel like a quarry would be the best place to do that, especially a dual gauge quarry like the Blue Mountain.
Oh yeah, definitely.
Yeah, so I definitely do like having crossings and like elevated barriers and then plenty of sidings for quarry trucks. Rumblin' Bridge destination. So it's this item where you wind it up, and then when an engine rolls over the one trigger on it, it starts shaking.
Yeah.
And I figured that would be a cool item to put at a quarry where you could almost have it simulated like there's like an avalanche or, you know, they're blasting. So, you know, an engine's coming over the bridge while it's getting shook by an avalanche of some sort.
Yeah, sort of like in the movie when Blunden Bridge kills itself.
Yeah, it doesn't look much like Blunden Bridge at all, but I feel like it's still a cool gimmick that you could work easily into just about any quarry location. And now, the Sodor China Clay Pit set.
Mm-hmm.
As awesome as it is, it's also kind of strange because it's the clay pits, yet it's basically a mountain piece. Like, you go up onto these higher platforms. That's not how a clay pit works. At least I don't think it is. But you also have enough space underneath the platforms and like little tunnel portal like pieces that like you can have enough tracks sitting underneath it where you can say, okay, maybe the pits started up here and like they worked their way down or something. You can create a justification for it. Or you can just say, you know what? What the heck? It's a toy and it's cool and I don't care. But yeah, sometimes you just gotta have fun with it. Typically, when you see someone set up the clay pits in a layout context, it's literally just that piece with tracks running around it. Sometimes people actually have it run into Brendam, sometimes not so much. Actually, one thing I saw is that having the transition between Brendam and the clay pits be the old classic drawbridge, the shorter drawbridge. I know it was at one point repainted. They had like Brendam signs on it, and then it came with Salty. And I actually saw somewhere where someone like had that bridge be the transition from the clay pits to Brendam Docks, which I thought was cool. It was a nice way to like keep them kind of separated yet together. The roller coaster spiral. We kind of talked about how like half of that was in the Deluxe Mountain Quarry, but the Reneas and the roller coaster set, that version of that spiral piece, I think works great as a quarry piece, and probably as a it probably would work best as a Blue Mountain Quarry section, just because Blue Mountain Quarry is where all the crazy tracks are. Farquhar Quarry and the Clay Pits, they seem very traditional. Like you have your shed for the engines, you have your stone hoppers, you have your sidings, and you have like two or three mine shafts. Meanwhile, Blue Mountain Quarry, you have all of these high elevated tracks, and then you have all your tracks crossing over each other, and then you have mine shafts that you enter on the lower level, and then you exit up on the top level. And then you have Owen working as a narrow gauge elevator. So Blue Mountain Quarry is definitely like, if you're gonna have one crazy quarry, that's definitely the quarry where it's definitely most accurate. And if I could only represent one quarry on a layout, I don't think it would be Farquhar, because Farquhar is kind of limited. Mavis definitely works there. You can have Bill and Ben work there, but really that's kind of the extent of it. Blue Mountain Quarry, sure, it's kind of a stretch to have Mavis, Bill, Ben, and Fergus work there, but it still makes a bit more sense than putting the narrow gauge engines at Farquhar. So I think Blue Mountain Quarry is the perfect, if I'm going to have one quarry, this is it.
Blue Mountain Quarry is just so cool. That was one of the few things that they actually did correctly.
Yeah, and really, it's one of those new series locations that was consistently used, and that's what makes it a good new location. You have some of these locations that they're either just outlandish in their existence,
That walking
or
bridge that's gonna come out.
oh God.
I like to call it the AT-AT, the all-terrain armored Toby.
Yeah, so like you have these ones that are either outlandish in their existence, or they show up once and they're never seen again. We have a lot of abandoned mines that show
Yeah,
up for
why are
one
there so many
episode.
abandoned mines on Sodor? Was there a gold rush or a coal rush on Sodor in the 1850s, and once all the coal dried up, everyone abandoned their mines?
And here's the thing. There's one place where there's allowed to be more abandoned mines than we know what to do with, and that is along the Arlesdale Railway, because it used to be the
Yeah, there
Mid-Sodor
used to be the
Railway.
Mid-Sodor. It would make sense for there to be a
Yeah.
lot of abandoned mines, or even maybe the current day ballast quarry isn't even the first ballast quarry. Maybe there was another one, but then they just kept mining and mining, and then they eventually got all of the good rock out of ballast quarry, so they moved to a new location and they just left the old one there,
Yeah.
tracks and all.
But I feel like that's the only section of the island where we have any business having more abandoned quarries than we know what to do with. So actually let's talk about the coaling plant slash coal station, because we haven't talked about that.
Actually, that was always one of my favorite episodes. When I was really little, it was Put Upon Percy. Was that the name of the episode?
Yeah. Yeah,
Put Upon Percy. Because I loved it. I loved the inside of the mind. That was something I've always loved the Corys, and especially the inside bits of something that we never get to see usually. When we got to see the inside of the Cory, I loved that.
So anyway, the choline plant, like, there's really only two choline plant-centered destinations, but they're both pretty darn awesome. And they are the coal station, which I have wanted since I was a small child and still do not have.
I really want that.
Yeah,
and then I never knew about it, and then I saw Turtles' review on it, and I scoured eBay for one for a good price. Cheapest one I could find was like $150.
So that and the Coal Tipper from the Logan and the Big Blue Engine set are like the two coolest destinations. And of course, they're really hard to get a hold of.
Well, there's also the coal loader and the Crosby coal.
Well, yeah, there are coal hoppers, but also, like, how many coal hoppers are on the island of Sodor? It doesn't have to exactly be the coaling plant to
be a
coal hopper. Yeah. Like, that's something you could have just sitting right next to the sheds.
Exactly.
And, yeah, you can incorporate them into a coaling plant layout or section of the layout, but I feel like the coal station and the coal tipper are really important to bringing that together. First of all, the coal tipper was just a cool thing that showed up in the TV show, and then to have it so many years later, see it in a wooden railway format.
The coal tipper is the thing that both Percy and Toby got stuck on, right?
Yes.
Okay. Does that even exist in real life? It seems like something that would exist, but it's so outlandish that you wouldn't think that it does.
I think that actually exists, especially
It definitely seems like something that someone would think of.
But yeah, of course, the coal station. It's one of those destinations that. It's like the Snyder Cut of destinations for me. It's I have coveted it for so long that I feel like I have built up the hype for it so much that it can no longer live up to those expectations. Because for one, there's just so many ways that you could use it. I'd imagine that you could fit a crossing onto the piece and like have one track cross over into the coal crane. And like that crane, it detaches. It attaches by
It's like the cargo crane. That's the name. Wow, that's the name of it. Just cargo crane.
Oh, the Sodor cargo crane.
Yellow one. I actually own that. Yeah. Mine's broken because the track came off of the main wall.
I have the old style one, and you know what, we'll discuss it a bit because it came in a quarry set, so you know.
Wait,
you can have this
quarry set.
It was like the quarry mine tunnel set where it came with the quarry mine tunnel, Percy and Mavis, and then a cargo crane. I have the older style cargo crane, but the peg that the crane sits into the slidey thing.
Yeah.
That I guess it was loose when I got it, but I didn't know until I had it set up on a layout and my foot accidentally bumped it, and it was just enough to make it go loose rest of the way. It's fine, like I can still use it. I just need to glue the peg back in. I've been lazy and haven't done it yet.
Those pesky pegs.
So yeah, I guess we were on the coal station before I went to the cargo crane. But I imagine you could probably also, like, line, like, one or two of them up. And because you can remove the cranes, like, if you would put two coal stations right next to each other and line up their, I'm going to call it the hopper track, so that it connects to each other.
Conveyor belt?
Yeah, where the conveyor belt dumps the coal into the hopper, or into the truck, whatever. So you could probably, like, connect them side by side. Maybe you'd need, like, a piece of track between them, but still pretty close to each other. And then you could have, like, a crane on the left side of the one coal station and on the right side of the other coal station. You could either have it that a track switches off and then, you know, runs alongside the coal station and through the crane. Or you could have it that the track from the crane crosses over the track from the coal station with a crossing. And then you can find a way to work the coal tipper in there. It's just, there's all sorts of nice, awesome track combinations that you can do with those destinations. And that's one of the things I love about layout building is crazy ways of making the tracks.
You'll never run out of ideas.
Honestly, I think we've said quite a good deal on quarries. We've kind of covered all of our bases here. Thanks for tuning in, everyone. This has been Rudy Productions, a.k.a. Dustin.
And Flying Scott Films, a.k.a. Dax.
Thank you for tuning in, everybody. See y'all next time.